Ara, a commissioner, agus a gwine uisle. Tugan si anna mordom, mila falcha corlo avinu, qui costa, clostan garda shikana. Tam kinta gur la brudul tavacht e sha, darna gardi nua, agus ta sulagum gur winhig shiv tanav as. Tam mila falcha rov gulair. Minister McEntee, Commissioner Harris, distinguished guests, and most of all, you, the families and friends of our newly attested Gardaí, it is my pleasure to welcome you here today to the Garda College on the occasion of the attestation and passing out ceremony of Intake 233, where 165 women and men from across various communities, backgrounds, and nationalities become members of An Garda Síochána. I would especially like to welcome our newly attested Gardaí to what is a very special and proud occasion for each of them and to each of their invited guests who have supported them in their journey so far. Ladies and gentlemen, today begins the career of our newly attested Gardaí in An Garda Síochána. They have successfully completed the first of three phases required of the Garda training program that they are undertaking. The next two phases of that training program will be delivered in the live operational policing environment that they now join. The attainment of the BA degree qualification at the end of the foundation program allows An Garda Síochána to publicly demonstrate a quest for excellence in the delivery of police training, thus allowing improved policing services to communities right across the country. The staff and I here in the college are very proud today to have played a part in ensuring that the probationer Gardaí of Intake 233 have developed skills to allow them to immediately go into service of An Garda Síochána throughout the country, where they'll put that learning into practice. I now invite Garda John Ivers and Garda Donal Dahan, our drill instructors, to lead Intake 233 onto the square and to commence the parade. Ladies and gentlemen, in accordance with Section 16 of the Garda Síochána Act 2005, I now invite the women and men of Intake 233 to make a solemn oath or declaration of service to the public as a member of An Garda Síochána, Ireland's National Police and Security Service. Cumplocht, Ara. I'll say aye and repeat your name. Aye. Hereby solemnly and sincerely declare before God, that I will faithfully discharge the duties of a member of An Garda Síochána with fairness, integrity, regard for human rights, with diligence and impartiality, upholding the Constitution and the laws, and according equal respect to all people, while I continue to be a member of An Garda Síochána. I will, to the best of my skill and knowledge, discharge all my duties according to law. And I do not belong to, and will not, while I remain a member of An Garda Síochána, form, belong to, or subscribe to, any political party or secret society whatsoever. Ladies and gentlemen of Intake 233, welcome each one of you to An Garda Síochána. Please give them a big round of applause. I would now like to invite Superintendent Kieran Rowan to accompany Commissioner Harris and Minister McEntee onto the front square to meet our newly attested probationer Gardaí and to present them with their identification cards. I will now hand you over to Garda Gail O'Donoghue of our foundation training team, who will introduce each individual newly attested Gardaí to you. And feel free to give a cheer and a round of applause when you hear your family member or friends.
Garda Finn McHale from Carlo to be stationed at Bridewell, Daymore. Garda Robert Hamilton from Leitrim to be stationed at Ballymun. Garda Kieran Dermody from Monaghan to be stationed at Kevin Street. Garda Damien Kelly from Dublin to be stationed at Kevin Street. Garda Ronan Kelly from Dublin to be stationed at Clondalkin. Garda Blake O'Donoghue from Cork to be stationed at Portlaoise. Garda Corey Flynn from Kildare to be stationed at Kevin Street. Garda Dean Whelan from Waterford to be stationed at Clonmel. Garda Ian Brown from Wexford to be stationed at Kevin Street. Garda Rebecca Lane from Offaly to be stationed at Kevin Street. Garda Joseph Whitty from Kilkenny to be stationed at Dundrum, DMR. Garda Sienna Marr from Westmead to be stationed at Leakslip. Garda Christina McNamara from Dublin to be stationed at Pierce Street. Garda Jennifer Forrestal from Donegal to be stationed at Navan. Garda Aoife McGinn from Tyrone to be stationed at Talla. Garda Danielle Toher from Dublin to be stationed at Store Street. Garda Saoirse O'Hanlon from Cavan to be stationed at Finglas. Garda Alyssa O'Sullivan from Kerry to be stationed at Portlaoise. Garda Aveen Dumphy from Kildare to be stationed at Talla. Garda Lauren Henderson from Cavan to be stationed at Mountjoy. Garda Tara Devlin from Mayo to be stationed at Golliv. Garda Brianna Doody from Kilkenny to be stationed at Wexford. Garda Elizabeth Kelly from Meath to be stationed at Raheny. Garda Robert Hegarty from Donegal to be stationed at Letterkenny. Garda Siobhan Hayes from Cork to be stationed at Clonmel. Garda Keith Dunleavy from Sligo to be stationed at Longford. Garda John O'Brien from Dublin to be stationed at Donnybrook. Garda Nathan Nolan from Kildare to be stationed at Clondalkin. Garda Leo Fallon from Dublin to be stationed at Store Street. Garda Gary Costello from Mayo to be stationed at Blanchardstown. Garda Kevin Burke from Galway to be stationed at Blackrock Dunmore. Garda Anthony McNamara from Clare to be stationed at Bray. Garda Ray Outram from Meath to be stationed at Ballymun. Garda Luke O'Malley from Dublin to be stationed at Pear Street. Garda Senan Farrell from Roscommon to be stationed at Store Street. Garda Cahill McCarthy from Kerry to be stationed at Anglesey Street. Garda Michael Riley from Meath to be stationed at Store Street. Garda Thomas Stack from Limerick to be stationed at Henry Street. Garda Shane McCabe from Dublin to be stationed at Talla. Garda Adam Dolan from Meath to be stationed at Coolock. Garda Gavin Keegan from Tipperary to be stationed at Henry Street. Garda Glenn Burke from Dublin to be stationed at Balbriggan. Garda Matthew McNamara from Cork to be stationed at Kilkenny. Garda Aoife Coffey from Kerry to be stationed at Grána Brothair. Garda Darren McGilloway from Derry to be stationed at Monaghan. Garda Paul O'Flynn from Laois to be stationed at Enniscorthy. Garda Claire Kennefic from Cork to be stationed at Middleton. Garda Sarah Heelan from Cork to be stationed at Waterford. Garda Hugh Graney from Limerick to be stationed at Newbridge. Garda Rebecca Fitzsimons from Kildare to be stationed at Talla. Garda Amy Bagg from Leitrim to be stationed at Store Street. Garda Kate O'Brien Laidlaw from Dublin to be stationed at Store Street. Garda Niamh Keegan from Kildare to be stationed at Mountjoy. Garda Rachel O'Mahony from Cork to be stationed at Mountjoy. Garda Sarah Peppard from Wicklow to be stationed at Ballyfermot. Garda Maeve Hughes from Kildare to be stationed at Talla. Garda Lap Sang Tang from Dublin to be stationed at Store Street. Garda Julianne Barry from Dublin to be stationed at Store Street. Garda Aldo Godja from Limerick to be stationed at Tipperary Town. Garda Sarah Finnegan from Louth to be stationed at Ballymun. Garda Sinead Roach from Limerick to be stationed at Fermoy. Garda Daniel Devlin from Derry to be stationed at Raheny. Garda Dylan Cronin from Cork to be stationed at Grána Brothar. Garda Owen O'Donoghue from Sligo to be stationed at Ashburn. Garda Rory O'Gallagher from Donegal to be stationed at Navan. Garda Dean Kirwan from Waterford to be stationed at Blanchardstown. Garda Matthew O'Neill Boyle from Dublin to be stationed at Dunleary. Garda Kieran Canning from Donegal to be stationed at Coolock. Garda Jacob Maloney from Wicklow to be stationed at Ronanstown. Garda Jason Doran from Kildare to be stationed at Bridewell DMR. Garda Geoffrey Mullen from Donegal to be stationed at Monaghan. And Garda Ewan O'Dwyer from Wicklow to be stationed at Talla. Garda Harry Nile from Westmead to be stationed at Dundrum DMR. Garda Fernando McTiernan from Wicklow to be stationed at Crumlin. Garda Dylan Brennan from Kerry to be stationed at Terenure. Garda Kenneth O'Reilly from Cork to be stationed at Clonmel. Garda Shane Bradley from Sligo to be stationed at Dunleary. Garda Darren Garvey from Galway to be stationed at Portlaoise. Garda Paul Farrelly from Kildare to be stationed at Ballyfermot. Garda Gerard O'Keenan from Dublin to be stationed at Kevin Street. Garda Anthony Murphy from Dublin to be stationed at Mountjoy. Garda Jack McCabe from Dublin to be stationed at Blanchardstown. Garda Devon Ging from Kildare to be stationed at Ballyfermot. Garda Alexandria Walsh Vaughan from Cork to be stationed at Enniscorthy. Garda Fina Cassidy from Dublin to be stationed at Ronanstown. Garda Dara McCarthy from Kildare to be stationed at Kevin Street. Garda Idel Canavan from Galway to be stationed at Blanchardstown. Garda Thomas Walsh from Cork to be stationed at Kilkenny. Garda Caroline Butler Hallisey from Wexford to be stationed at Rathmines. Garda Ruth Redmond from Meath to be stationed at Raheny. Garda Neil O'Reilly from Wicklow to be stationed at Talla. Garda Katagina Capron from Kilkenny to be stationed at Blackrock DMR. Garda Megan Cooney from Kilkenny to be stationed at Bray. Garda Eve Mooney from Tipperary to be stationed at Carlow. Garda Kira Marr from Tipperary to be stationed at Waterford. Garda Lisa Donoghue from Galway to be stationed at Ashburn. Garda Molly Maguire from Meath to be stationed at Balbriggan. Garda Rachel O'Brien from Offaly to be stationed at Drogheda. Garda Joanna Witkowska from Sligo to be stationed at Longford. Garda Clodagh MacDonald from Clare to be stationed at Ballymun. Garda Caitlin Carolyn from Monaghan to be stationed at Finglas. Garda Daniel Hurley from Kerry to be stationed at Coolock. Garda Kieran Bagnall from Kildare to be stationed at Ballymun. Garda Conor Normoyle from Kilkenny to be stationed at Wicklow. Garda Christopher Irwin from Cork to be stationed at Middleton. Garda Sean McConnell from Dublin to be stationed at Finglas. Garda Catherine McCarthy from Waterford to be stationed at Crumlin. Garda Niall McMahon from Meath to be stationed at Balbriggan. Garda Brian Morris from Limerick to be stationed at Waterford. Garda Noel Ward from Roscommon to be stationed at Finglas. Garda Fintan Connaughton from West Meath to be stationed at Ashburn. Garda Cahill Daly from Waterford to be stationed at Coolock. Garda Christian O'Shea from Dublin to be stationed at Pierce Street. Garda Jason Hand from Monaghan to be stationed at Ballymun. Garda Connor Shortall from Kerry to be stationed at Bridewell DMR. Garda Owen Hayes from Wexford to be stationed at Sundrive Road. Garda Bradley Nealon from Sligo to be stationed at Dundalk. Garda Peter Goggins from Cork to be stationed at Waterford. Garda Kyle McGurran from Leitrim to be stationed at Cavan. Garda John MacDonald from Leash to be stationed at Kevin Street. Garda Connor Dalton from Wexford to be stationed at Bray. Garda Finn Prendival Brown from Kerry to be stationed at Finglas. Garda Gavin Jones from Mayo to be stationed at Talla. Garda Keane Reynolds from Wicklow to be stationed at Bridewell DMR. Garda Connor O'Hora from Mayo to be stationed at Blanchardstown. Garda Adam Galligan from Dublin to be stationed at Pierce Street. Garda Sean McGreevy from Dublin to be stationed at Mountjoy. Garda Stephen O'Shea from Waterford to be stationed at Wicklow. Garda Conor Leahy from Tipperary to be stationed at Leixlip. Garda Damien Gore from Cork to be stationed at Anglesey Street. Garda Craig McParkland from Dublin to be stationed at Ballymun. Garda Andrew Maloney from Limerick to be stationed at Waterford. Garda James Clark from Galway to be stationed at Navan. Garda Chloe Devitt from Clare to be stationed at Bray. Garda Rory Mahon from Kildare to be stationed at Enniscorthy. Garda Rebecca Fogarty from Tipperary to be stationed at Waterford. Garda Stephen Clark from Sligo to be stationed at Dundalk. Garda Brandon O'Brien from Wicklow to be stationed at Pierce Street. Garda Lauren Malloy from Mayo to be stationed at Clondalkin. Garda Kira Hawk from Tipperary to be stationed at Port Leash. Garda Laura Barrett from Mayo to be stationed at Blanchardstown. Garda Vivian Gahan from Wexford to be stationed at Kevin Street. Garda Samantha Homan from Wexford to be stationed at Lucan. Garda Niamh O'Sullivan from Meath to be stationed at Dundalk. Garda Amelia Cullen from Wicklow to be stationed at Waterford. Garda Laura Buckman from Limerick to be stationed at Newbridge. Garda Stephanie Carter from Leash to be stationed at Kevin Street. Garda Shane McGarry from Westmeath to be stationed in Crumlin. Garda Jamie Ring from Mayo to be stationed at Blanchardstown. Garda Evelyn Doherty from Donegal to be stationed at Letterkenny. Garda Kyle Queegan from Offaly to be stationed at Navan. Garda Emmanuel Samuel from Kilkenny to be stationed at Wicklow. Garda Matthew Daly from Dublin to be stationed at Store Street. Garda Kaylee Millward from Cork to be stationed at Carlow. Garda Mark Hughes from Longford to be stationed at Clondalkin. Garda Adam O'Dwyer from Kerry to be stationed at Finglas. Garda Adam Gagan from Meath to be stationed at Blanchardstown. Garda Killian Seward from Waterford to be stationed at Clonmel. Garda Mantis Skersonis from Louth to be stationed at Raheny. Garda Adam Taylor from Galway to be stationed at Bray. Garda Luke Powell from Roscommon to be stationed at Sundrive Road. Garda Dennis O'Connor from Kerry to be stationed at Mountjoy. Garda Oisín O'Toole from Galway to be stationed at Bray. Garda Davidus Grudzinskas from Offaly to be stationed at Lucan. Garda Sean McLaughlin from Dublin to be stationed at Blanchardstown. And Garda Jack McElroy from Galway to be stationed at Rathmines.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now come to the awards part of the ceremony, where four prizes are awarded. The first award is for the fittest class. The fittest initiative challenges trainee Gardaí to attain the title of the fittest class. This was initiated in Garda College under the guidance of the foundation training staff. And the purpose of this initiative is to encourage each class to develop their fitness levels during phase one of their training while working as a team. The preparation involved a combination of aerobic speed runs, speed agility runs, and circuit classes. The challenge itself involved a beep test, which the fittest class averaged a score of 9.61. And this award is sponsored by Cosha Shimsa. The winner of the fittest class in intake 233 is class 233F. And I'd like to call on the class senior, Garda Emmanuel Samuel, to collect the award on behalf of class 223F. The next award is the International Police Association Garda College Scholarship Award. This award is in memory of Ned Joy. The foundation training program places a significant emphasis on teamwork and it's fundamentally important to the problem-based learning approach, which is a core principle of the trainee programme here in the Garda College. The receipt of this award has displayed significant strengths in teamwork during phase one of the programme, and this is a quality that's cherished at all levels within a Garda Síochána. The receipt of the award has been selected by the staff in the Garda College for being the best team worker, and the IPA scholarship is awarded to Garda John MacDonald. Garda MacDonald is from Ballyfoyle, County Laois. Prior to commencing training Garda Síochána, he worked as a fabricator and completed stage two in Port Laois Garda Station. Has a keen interest in the GA, particularly football, and enjoys running. During his free time, Garda MacDonald volunteers the local community and has completed triathlons and 5K races to raise money for charity. And he's a consistent team worker throughout phase one and highly respected by the staff in the Garda College who nominated him. The next award is the Gary Sheehan Memorial Medal. The Gary Sheehan Memorial Medal commemorates recruit Garda Gary Sheehan, who died on duty, who was murdered on duty in Ballinamore, County Leitrim, on the 16th of December 1983. And this memorial medal is awarded to the best all-round student. The recipient of this award has contributed significantly to life at the Garda College, has proven themselves in the operational environment, and has distinguished themselves in the academic field. The winner has shown leadership qualities and has won the respect of their peers and authorities. The Gary Sheehan Memorial Medal is awarded to Garda Rachel O'Mahony. Garda O'Mahony is from Skull, County Cork. Prior to commencing training with an Garda Síochána, she worked as a primary school teacher. She graduated in 2022 from Mary Immaculate College with a Bachelor of Education and a Certificate in Religious Education. Garda O'Mahony has a keen interest in sport and fitness, enjoys running, swimming, basketball and sailing, was a member of Skull Rowing Club and participated in the All-Ireland Rowing Championships. She presents herself in a courteous and friendly manner throughout her training and has consistently displayed leadership qualities and highly respected here. The final prize from this intake is the Commissioner's Prize. The Commissioner's Medal is awarded to the student achieving the highest aggregate mark in the academic subjects on the completion of phase one of the BA Applied Policing Programme. The winner has excelled in studies in the subject areas of including the foundations of policing, policing with communities, crime and incident policing, traffic policing, station roles and responsibilities, professional competence, as well as officer and public safety. These subjects are operationally focused on the craft of policing, and the winner of this award has excelled in demonstrating their competence to become a very efficient and effective police person. I'm pleased to announce the Commissioner's Medal is awarded to Garda Ian Brown. Garda Brown is from Clonard, County Wexford, and before commencing training in Garda Síochána, he graduated from SETU in 2023 with a Bachelor of Arts in Criminal Justice Studies. He also worked in hospitality before joining us in Garda Síochána, has a keen interest in fitness, including running and soccer, and plays the guitar. And he was stationed in Nude Ross during his phase one, stage two of his training, and has engaged enthusiastically in the foundation training, and well done to him. Now, passing out ceremonies in the Garda College are significant occasions. They're proud events where our new probationers get to showcase their drill display for you, their friends, family and invited guests. And it's an opportunity to highlight their achievements. Unfortunately, not all intakes get to experience a passing out. The previous intake, 232, owing to organisational policing demands, were attested early. And today I have the pleasure of welcoming back the prize recipients of that intake to accept their awards. And I trust each of you will give them a round of applause when I call out their names. The IPA scholarship for intake 232 is awarded to Garda Sarah Dermody. Garda Dermody is from Johnstown, County Kilkenny. She was stationed in Port Laois during stage two of her training, and prior to commencing training, she worked as a healthcare worker. Has a keen interest in sport, particularly camogie, and Garda Dermody has won a minor and intermediate county final medal with St. Anne's in Kilkenny. She was crowned junior and senior camogie player of the year while attending school, and is an active member of the International Police Association and a very consistent team worker. The Gary Sheehan Memorial Medal for Intake 232 is awarded to Garda Manus Murphy. Garda Murphy is from Ballyfermot, County Dublin, and before commencing training in Garda Síochána, he worked as a manager of a retail outlet. Garda Murphy has a keen interest in jiu-jitsu and spent some time in Australia before joining us, where he took part in martial arts training with the Australian police. He hosted women's martial arts self-defence seminars in his local gym in Sydney, and I think this engagement with Australian police helped him to form a decision to return home to Ireland to join in Garda Síochána. And the final prize is the Commissioner's Medal for Intake 232. It's awarded to Garda Niamh Mallon. Garda Mallon is from Navan, County Meath. Before commencing training at Garda Síochána, she worked as a pharmacist in Dublin. She graduated from Trinity in 2016 with a Bachelor of Science Pharmacy degree, and in 2017 completed a Master's degree from the RCSI. While attending Trinity, Garda Mallon was actively involved in organising a number of charity events, has a keen interest in travelling and reading, and she was stationed in Ashbourne, County Meath during Stage 2. And she's engaged also enthusiastically and has achieved the highest aggregate marks for her intake. So finally, I would like to call on Commissioner Harris now to address you.
Sorry, the wind's playing havoc with the table here. Minister McEntee, invited guests, my new colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon to you all. You're all very welcome to the Garda College for this very happy occasion, and I'm delighted to be here, and I have to say these are the very best of days as Commissioner of Garda Síochána. Today marks a very special day for you, and also for your families and loved ones. It is the day that you will begin your career as a Garda. It's a proud day and one that brings people together in celebration. And as you celebrate, I might point to those who are here today who have made all of that possible. Thank you to your families, to your loved ones, and your colleagues gathered around you today for their continued support. And Garda Síochána is built upon the hard work, dedication and commitment given by its Gardaí and staff. As one of the most trusted police services in the world, the vast majority of people in Ireland believe in Garda Síochána delivers a good service. And this significant achievement has been made possible by the foundations laid by others who have passed through this college and indeed who have stood where you are now standing today. And from today, you will join them in this proud organisation and strengthen it. As you embark on your new career, I want to remind you that having and giving support is hugely important, because this work, while rewarding, is not without its difficulties. You deal with incidents on a daily basis that can be stressful and traumatic, but while it can be incredibly busy and challenging, there are supports to guide you and assist you. As the backbone of the organisation, it is crucial that you are supported in what you do, whether that be in the area of mental wellbeing supports or operational equipment or training. That is why we've made improvements in these areas under a policing service for our future. Among the supports you can expect is access to support, peer support network, the Gardaí Employee Assistance Service, the COPS Wellbeing App, and our independent 24-hour counselling service. And I encourage you to make use of these supports and the support of your sergeants and more experienced Garda colleagues. Of course, having the right support to do your job is so important. Enhanced personal safety equipment has recently been introduced, including stronger incapacitant spray. Like all of your personal equipment, it is there to protect you and indeed the society we serve. It is there to use if you need to do so. And Garda Síochána also continues to invest in technology to support and protect frontline Gardaí. You've already have received our world-leading mobility device, and this will greatly assist you and will enable you to spend more time on patrol, while the introduction of body-worn cameras will enhance Garda safety. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank you all for choosing a career in Garda Síochána. And as I said to you earlier, it is an exciting career and one that is hugely rewarding and fulfilling. It is a career offering many possibilities and opportunities. For instance, through the investments we've made in training, you're able to upskill in many areas such as human rights, economic crime, cybercrime, and serious crime investigation. Not only that, but this job offers great opportunities to advance. Of course, we do want to grow the organisation and is hoped to get to 15,000 Gardaí in time, which will mean new colleagues for you. And our most recent recruitment campaign received over 6,300 applications, which is very reassuring. Indeed, I know some of you were involved in promoting this campaign by sharing your experience of the training programme. We are also eager to diversify as an organisation and are proud to be members of the 30% Club. And meanwhile, 31% of those applying to this recent recruitment campaign were women. Furthermore, a high proportion of applicants, almost 25%, noted their ethnicity as being other than white Irish. This is all very encouraging as we seek to ensure that Garda Síochána is truly representative and reflective of all the people of Ireland whom we serve. It shows that across a wide spectrum of society that many people think being a Gardaí is a job worth doing. It's also positive for you and potential recruits that the mandatory age of recruitment will soon be increased to 62 years. And very shortly, you will leave through these gates to begin your careers as Gardaí. And you will not leave what you've learnt here behind you, nor will your education cease. You will continue to expand your skills. You will do so proactively policing with communities by interacting and engaging with people each and every day, because community policing is the heart of all we have to do. Already you have shown your commitment and drive whilst in training, and I know a number of you have already received compliments and indeed commendation for the assistance that you provided. When called upon, you have ably reported for duty and worked extra hours at short notice. So I want to thank you all for this work and for the commitment you've given to date. Today is an immensely proud and important day for you all. Thank you for your hard work and commitment. As Gardaí, you will protect democracy, protect the vulnerable, and protect the human rights of everyone you come in contact with. By working together in a spirit of mutual respect and doing our best for the country, you will play your part in Garda Síochána continuing to deliver a high quality policing and security service that keeps the people of Ireland safe. I want to wish each and every one of you every success in your career, and I look forward to working with you. I congratulate you on becoming members of Garda Síochána. Thank you all. Thanks very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner. I'd like to now invite Minister McEntee to address you.
I apologise, I'll try not keep you too long. Commissioner Harris, distinguished guests, family and friends, but above all to our newest members of Garda Síochána, it's such an honour and really a pleasure to join you today for what I know is a very special day, not just for you, but for all of your family and friends and loved ones. I have to say, this is one of the nicest parts of the job that I do, and the fact that there are 166 members here today, it's the largest attestation, and you look so impressive, and every single one of us here are so proud of you. So congratulations. I also want to say thank you thank you sincerely for choosing a career in An Garda Síochána. There's many career paths that you could have chosen, but you have decided to join An Garda Síochána, and as Minister for Justice and on behalf of all of our citizens, we are eternally grateful, and I hope that in many years to come you will be as happy now or as happy then as you are now at the choice that you have made. Today is an important day, so please make sure that you celebrate. I'm a big believer that any milestone in our life we should celebrate, not just yourselves with fellow recruits, as I'm sure you have already, but make sure you celebrate with family and friends. These are the people who have gotten you where you are today. These are the people who will continue to support you in your career and who you will continue to rely on as you begin this new journey. Support and understanding from family and friends will be so important to help you along the way. And I want to acknowledge the family and friends here and acknowledge your role as well. None of us know what any day holds, but when your loved ones put on this uniform and go out to work, you are putting on a uniform and you are working like no other. You are there to respond and to help victims. You are a trusted face in moments of real crisis or tragedy. And speaking personally, it is such an important role that you have for so many people to confront the criminal elements of our society who seek to undermine the safety of our communities, to maintain the security of the state in times of emergency, as you as an organisation have done for many decades, and to uphold and to promote the values of An Garda Síochána. The values of An Garda Síochána, they matter. Honesty, accountability, respect, professionalism and empathy. These matter. They are what has enabled our Gardaí to build a relationship with the Irish people over the last century, a relationship which is based on trust and based on respect, a relationship which, let me tell you, having been to New York, having met with the NYPD, having been to the UK and engaging with colleagues across Europe, you are the envy of many police services right around the world. As you live these values in your daily work, you will also require courage. We know that, but we put our trust in each and every one of you to display that courage, because we also know the training that you've received here in Templemore, in human rights and in policing will stand you in good stead as you join the ranks of the many courageous men and courageous women who have served and continue to serve our communities with distinction. Days like today, of course, are always good for communities as well, because they remind those of us in them that more and more Gardaí are arriving in them. And let's be honest, who doesn't want to see more Gardaí in our communities? We need Gardaí on our streets and in our communities. The visible presence of Gardaí alone makes people feel safer and, of course, also keeps people safe. So as Minister, one of my priorities is to ensure that we strengthen An Garda Síochána. During 2023 recruitment, it gained real momentum and recruits are now passing out of this college, I'm pleased to say, every couple of months. 746 new trainees entered Templemore last year. This was the highest intake into our Garda College since 2018, and I am absolutely encouraged, as the Commissioner has said, that we will be able to reach our target of 15,000, but go beyond that, and I think we need to. The Commissioner and I are doing everything that we can with our teams to ensure that we reach it. We've already increased the age limit from 35 to 50. We've recently announced plans to increase the retirement age from 60 to 62. We've increased the allowance here in the training college, acknowledging that you need more, and there's more and more that we will do. We're also further resourcing the entire Garda workforce, meaning more Garda staff and more reserves, and we're well on our way to reaching our target of 4,000 staff. Staff are essential working with An Garda Síochána. As the nature of crime changes, they perform vital roles that are essential to a modern policing service, whether that's the investigation of financial crime, cyber crime, or the analysis of data. They also provide significant support that help our frontline Gardaí to do our jobs, and importantly, they free up trained, skilled, professional Gardaí from behind desks to be deployed to the frontline. We'll also have a reserve campaign to be launched shortly. We've set a target by 2026 to reach 1,000, and they will be there to support you and to work with you in your jobs. It's so important, as the Commissioner said, that An Garda Síochána reflect the communities that we all live in. And our most recruitment campaign, which attracted 6,300 people, really is from such a diverse range of candidates. As has been mentioned, we've reached out to new communities, and there is an unprecedented dividend that we're seeing from that. 32% of applicants as well are women, and I'm delighted to see so many women in our graduation ceremony today. And 40%... Here's to the ladies. Exactly. And 40% of our applicants for the 2024 competition were over 35. All of this is welcome. It's all progress. It's all positive. We are all moving in the right direction. Of course, we do expect that An Garda Síochána will be a world-class policing service, and we recognise for that we must give you the tools, the technology, the equipment, everything that you need and that you require for modern policing. So we've now introduced legislation that will allow for body-worn cameras for Gardaí for the first time. These cameras will not only play a vital role in the work that you do in prosecutions, but they're also there to protect you. We have seen online incidents far too often being recorded by members of the public. It's not right. Garda body cams will put you on a level footing. They have the potential to deter attacks against you or any of your colleagues, such as the ones that we saw in Dublin last November, or where they do not prevent them, they will provide the evidence that we need to help bring culprits to justice. So the rollout of body-worn cameras is a priority for me, and I know it's a priority for the Commissioner and his team. Another priority is to ensure that you have the technology to be able to do your job as quickly and as efficiently as possible. The new legislation on facial recognition technology, for example, is progressing, and this will dramatically save time for the work that you and your colleagues do in some of the most serious cases. Some new technology, as the Commissioner has mentioned, is already in place, making a positive difference. And I think with the rollout of Garda mobile devices complete, every Garda now has access to real time in a series of apps. This is to eliminate paperwork, to allow you to carry out your frontline duties far more efficiently. And of course, we know that it can be challenging, it can be difficult, it can be stressful, and sometimes it can be even traumatic, the work that you have to deal with. So it is an absolute priority, and it has been for me from the outset, to protect the health, to protect the safety, to protect the well-being of each and every one of you here. I hope that this is reflected in the commitment for this budget alone, where €6 million was allocated for well-being initiatives, for additional medical costs, for 2,500 units of body armour, and we will do much more. This is just some of what we are doing to acknowledge that while we can't completely eliminate the stress of the difficult job that you are asked to do, we can certainly express our gratitude as we ensure you have access to the right supports if and when we need them. And so I would reiterate, remember, it's not a strength, or it's not a weakness, it's a strength to ask for help. So if you do need help to access supports that are put in place to look after yourself, please access them. Finally, I just want to thank you once again for your commitment, the commitment that you are making to your country here today. And as you stand here, it's an important day for you, as I said, for your family, for all of your loved ones. I hope that you are filled with a deep sense of pride, as all of us are here. And as you go through your time in An Garda Síochána, you'll do different jobs, you'll work with different people, you'll deal with different communities. Some of you might choose to work with victims of domestic and sexual violence in the Divisional Protective Service Unit. Some of you might deal with an evolving problem of cybercrime. Some of you might work in our roads policing units, keeping people safe on our roads, and community policing, drugs and organised crime. There are so many areas that you can work in. Whatever you choose to do, whatever path you take, I wish you every single success. Your willingness to serve and to protect, to build relationships across the community, will continue to be the basis for the trust that the Irish public have in you as members of An Garda Síochána. So I hope you have an enjoyable day. Enjoy the celebrations. You've earned us. Every success in your future careers. Cogorgigas. Thank you.
So to conclude, I'd like to thank the Minister for Justice, the Commissioner, and our distinguished guests, and most of all, the family and friends of our newly attested Gardaí for your attendance here today. In particular, I'd like to thank the Garda Band under the direction of Inspector Pat Kenny, and the presence of the Garda Band, as always, has added a special extra dimension to this ceremony. So thank you, Pat. So Minister McEntee and the Commissioner will be available for photographs for a short time immediately after the ceremony. So I call upon Inspector Amanda Reynolds to prepare intake 233. And I now call upon the Garda Band to play Oran Naveen. Thank you.
Charlie Bird, RTÉ News.
Ask him if he has a spare bike.
Ask him if he has a spare bike.
I used to get that now. They're all one gun off.